I'm Stephen. Welcome to CG Films. Today we're doing some gameplay with some commentary of Blazing Chrome. Not as in this sort of Blazing Chrome, than is Chrome eating my blooming RAM as it does. But yes, is Blazing Chrome, which is basically a, like, sort of like Contra, I should say, when it comes to them sort of games. You know, like your good old Nintendo Entertainment System kind of Contra. And it's got that similar art style to similar sort of like NES games. Not saying bad kind of artwork, but it is a nice artwork that fits the somewhat theme when it comes to like NES games. Ooh, too bright. Lol, it's really sunny today as it is. Oh, not a vampire. Made by so-and-so. And so-and-so. And so-and-so and so. Then it is published by them, that company, because I had to look up on Twitter since this morning, knowing the internet, whatever, to know when this blooming game comes out. Because none of this is launched on certain platforms, but also it's available with Xbox Game Pass, which I'm currently playing, which I am a subscriber to Xbox Game Pass. And yeah, since this is a Contra-like game, I wonder if this would utilise the Konami code. Let's give that a try. Anyways, what was it? I don't think that will work. I gave it a try. I don't think that will work regards on the Konami code that is Contra-like games. I like how my profile picture on Xbox Live is all pixelated. That's cool. That's a little neat touch, I should say. Anyways, let's play some arcade mode. Play on easy, despite utilising some more of the Konami code. You know, you get more lives when playing on easy. It's easy like Sunday morning. Anyways, let's play on easy. And we've got some certain characters. Even someone who looks like Shinobi. That's quite neat. But you got other characters, I don't know if there'll be DLC characters or updated characters in the meantime, but we'll play the robotic dude that looks like a Terminator.
I'll be back.
Anyways, but yeah, I did have the little go, despite even it, where the difficulty it's on, it's still quite hard. Because, you know, the original Contra games entirely are quite hard entirely. But let's do this, because I did do the somewhat first level, and the boss was quite hard. But I'll give it a go either way, despite what I've already played. Bang, bang, bang. Oh, the good thing about this is, despite, you know, like on the NES controller, and it does have like an auto button, which I should stop really tapping, because this does have a auto button kind of thing, which is good, because certain games like this need an auto button. I should say, unless you have an NES Advantage, you know, that sort of control on the Super Nintendo, NES, you know, whatnot. But yeah, it's good that it has an auto button, that's for sure. There's, you know, when doing the look, it's not like I'm playing Contra or rope. Anyways, so we've got a shield thing. At least it's not heavy machine gun, you know, when it comes to them sort of games. Well, I'd rather save that, actually, because I got weather. You can switch in between weapons. Ooh. And I'm using all my blooming grenade thingies, which shouldn't. But yeah, there's options to switch in between weapons. Yeah, I just do like this sort of game. I never play much of the Contra games. I do have it on Xbox Live Arcade, which is also backwards compatible, by the way. But I never played it originally, I should say. Unless knowing them game. No! Oh, thank God. Because they literally do like a rip thing, you know, like them great Gradius things, you know, from Smash Bros. Like, then touch you off the screen. And I actually died from one of them bug things. No, you're not picking me up. You're not going getting me ripped from them, you know. Oh, there we go. Right, there we go. But yeah, despite the actual Contra games as is, I haven't played all that much. I played similar, you know, not just this, that are similar like games. I do like these. I've seen some games that are quite hard as a different topic. Oh yeah, but you know, it's got that nice retro feel regards them. You know, them sort of like retro feels than it is, then, you know, you die. Once you die, kind of die. You know, one hit me KO kind of thing. Ooh, you know, when it comes to that sort of one hit, one kill, you know, one hit, one kill kind of things. When it comes to them sort of retro games, you die, and all that. Anywho. Then get that to. Sorry, I should have ducked that. Ah, well, jump. Ah, dodge that. Whew, that was a nice one. Right. Up and at him. Oh, yeah. Ah! Come on, at least get me up there. Oh, no, you're not getting me this time. Ah, no. How do I get up there? Well, at least I don't have a screw attack, that's for sure. Oh, I need that. Ah, oh, damn it, disappeared, damn it. Oh, well. Things happen. Let's move on. Oh, this is the boss fight. Well, one of the boss fights, I should say, in this level, surprisingly, because there's... Ah! Multiple kind of boss fights, I should say. Oh, it's no! No, I still got one life left. I still got, you know, when it comes to them sort of retro games, you have at least one life by one by zero. No! Oh, damn it! Game over. Ah. Oh well. Continue. All right, let's try this again. Because I did go up to a bit where there's like a certain boss, and then it's like, this isn't my final form kind of boss. We shall get there eventually, hopefully on this, if not I might have to switch to a different level, if that's the case. Because I'm trying to like showcase the game, because it's one that's like, ah, oh, it's so hard, I can't showcase much of the game, but at least it gives you like level option. So you can actually switch in between, because I did that with Cuphead. It's like, ah, screw this, I'll show you a different level. But I need to play much more Cuphead, despite him, and doesn't have a cooperative option. Which, by the way, this does have a cooperative feature, but it's not available till launch, which is quite sad, really. So there goes my plan of, you know, streaming with my friend online with this when it has a cooperative feature. No!
We're gonna cry!
No. But it's a bit of a shame that it doesn't have online co-op on day one, which I was gonna plan to stream with my friend online, but well. I'll have to do it another time. Well, guys, what I'm going to stream for this weekend is another thing, because, damn it, this game kind of came out. Let's see how I'm going to do this with one life. So I literally just use that like a snake gun thing, because there's like this elephant kind of trunk-like snake weapon you can use. Similar to like a flamethrower in, you know, Contra and whatnot. Continue. Oh, there it is! Speak of the devil, I got it! And I died. And it's got caught. No, it's okay, I'm still alive. I had to keep that. Was that only one use only? And like a continuous bit of it. But, because I actually defeated that boss with utilizing the snake thing. Oh well. Could I get another one? Maybe not. Oh, I got a robot. Got a drone thing. Oh yeah, thanks for doing your part, you stupid robot. You did. You had one job, you stupid drone robots. Robots. They can never be loyal to you these days. Why am I having trouble playing this? Because I got to a certain bit in this game before recording, and I'm being dull at this. Speedbot. Let's just whip through this. Go away. Let's see if we can get a grenade. That'll do. Right, let's do this. Still got my speed bot.
Eat this!
Oh, wait until it's in the proper foreground. You gotta think fourth dimension, Steven. And I died, damn it. Why would you die? I died. I meant to dodge the business. There, now you're dead. You're nearly dead. Come on, die already. Just die, finally. You're dead now.
Liquid!
Anyways, but yeah, and this is the bit where I keep constantly repeating, I could do this bit, this is easy. You get a mech thing, you do this, I'm trying to whip through this so I can start the mech on the final boss bit. Because, go, just keep on moving. Oh, I still want my mech until the one of the boss fights. Ah, no, 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 don't die. Don't die on me, stupid mech. I need you, stupid mech. Oh, well, it's out. Goodbye, teammate. Black caught down much. Right, anyways. Moving on. I've got Weather Life on my blue mech still. And this is what I'm referring to. Oh, sorry, what's in the box? Okay, that'll do. Right, let's do this. Now this is the part when there's one of the bosses and he has a head, but that's now his final form, but I'm not going to spoil it. Ah, eject, eject! And then that causes a boom, which the mech did help him with the booms for damaging the boss thing. Just die, ah, damn it! Just die, 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 die. Oh no, no, no! It's raining balls! Damn it. Right, anyways. Come on, just die. Just die. No! Oh! That count! I still got one life-ish. Zero lives. Zero deaths. Yay. And this is the part what I was mentioned about. This is not my final form. This is my final form. Oh, God. It looks like Goldar from Power Rangers. Make my monster grow! Oh, it's okay. How am I going to do this with just one life? Well, by one, my zero, but counts as one. How's that logical when it comes to retro video games, I should say. Game over. Give up. It's alright. We'll try another level before ending this, I should say. Just have a quick another go on another level. So you can see another level, I guess. That's might be a bit more difficult than the first level, but we'll give it a go. Still keep on easy, like it's Sunday morning. Choose the robot. And we'll choose the second level and see how hard that is, because I never played the second level before recording this. Right, let's do this. Oh, three. Three difficulty in three. Oh, this is going to be fun. Ooh. Battletoads much. Battletoads. That's a game that I'm looking forward to whenever that balloon game comes out. It's been the Xbox Game Pass. But yeah, it's nice to play this with my Xbox Game Pass subscription. Is another thing. Let's just hope I don't do any dodging kind of stuff, you know, when it comes to the Battletoads. Oh no, there's a bomb. He's carrying bombs. No, whoa. At least they're not dodging fences, that's for sure. Ah! No, no, no. It's gonna be like one of those blooming frustrating games, not like Cuphead kind of frustrating, but you know, that sort of like NES kind of... Oh yeah, snake thing! Woo! Well, elephant, snake thing. Yeah, where were you when I was trying to deal with them bosses? Yeah, ran right at me, why don't you? Oh well. I was looking. Alone and trying to drive. Mostly driving, shooting, commentating, playing, you know, it's not like a streaming remote. Right? Ah, damn it! Too busy bouncing your blooming thing. It looks like one of those like circular motorbike things. There is next bit. Right, come on to me. Oh, that's a big thing. Come on. Ah, no. Ooh, nearly. Ah, no. How about no? How about no? Just die. Why would you die? Shoot the engines. Ah, no. Nope. Just die! Just, there we go! It's down! It's down! It's down! Finally! Black hole down. Part too much. Right, let's see what this is. A grenade thing. Ooh, ah! Hey, I saw you got like zero lives. Shame that something might not happen to you. What are the odds? Anyways, and continue, but not actually continue. I want to show you some other features that this game has. You know, when it comes to that retro feel, there are somewhat filters. There we go. You got like a CRT kind of filter, another CRT kind of filter, and it's got like this. So if you don't like the pixelated sprites or whatever, you can have it like this, which is quite neat, more kind of modern, I should say. So I can show you a little bit of that. So it looks like, yeah, screw in retro kind of blockiness. You got like this that looks less blocky. It looked like you blurred out a blocky image by the looks of it. But there's that option, so if you're not into them sort of retro kind of feels, you know, you've got that option also. But yeah, we'll leave it at that then. So that's my gameplay of Blazing Chroma. It's an interesting game, and despite playing with my Xbox Game Pass subscription, which kudos to Xbox Game Pass. But other than that though, yeah, it's a shame that at launch I can't play it cooperatively, so there goes an idea for a stream for this following Saturday. But despite that though, I thought I'd show some gameplays on whatever platforms it is nowadays, including the Nintendo Switch, which was great. Great for them Nintendo users, despite NESs, you know, when Contra kind of first came on home consoles. Anyways, I'm going to a tangent as I do. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.